I'm living in that 21st century, doing something.
Yo, what's going on? It's Kieran talking about the pickup stuff again. Let's go. So today we're gonna do a video about appearance. It's gonna be quite an in-depth one. This is a simple-ish topic, or we're gonna make it simple, in fact. But it's gonna be quite in-depth as well. And if you're less good with women, if you're sort of struggling to get any girls at all, or you almost get none, then this is gonna be really important for you, because there's probably gonna be things that you're doing that you could just eliminate. Like, it's really simple stuff. And a lot of what we're gonna go over here, the ethos is that we don't want to have this big barrier to entry, right? So we don't want this, just like a very big mountain that you have to climb before you look good enough. There's always this thing in pickup, it's just like, oh, when I've got the right tan, when I've got the right body, when I've got the right money, when I've got the right watch, then I'll be able to do it. It's like, that's all just excuse making bullshit. Like, we've got to get past that. We want the barrier to entry is very small. You don't need a big watch, you don't need to be the best looking guy, just get out there and make the best of yourself, right? So that's what we're gonna go over. Another thing to mention, obviously, it's a bit of a weird time to do a video on appearance when I've got a really aggressively shit haircut going on at the moment. But the point being, it's a work in progress. So it's a work in progress, so I'm all right. But this is gonna come through, and then we're gonna blonde this as well, so it should look a bit better, so tune in for that. But yeah, I might wear a hat actually if it's distracting, because it does look proper shite at the moment. But this is that we get onto an interesting point there, because a lot of what we're gonna talk about here is where your reality as a person, what you think, what your frame, your reality, where that meets objective reality, right? So it's like, you could, analogy here, you could really think of yourself as the best fighter in the world, right? And if you're not, then if you were to come up against the best fighter in the world, he'd beat you, right? That's what would happen, right?
More movement than he is now. He's allowing Mike Tyson to trap him in the corner.
And that's objective reality meeting your reality, and sort of objective reality is going to win. But in pickup, there's this is a concept that we're going to keep coming back to. And a lot of the time, we don't know where objective reality is a lot of the time. In sports, it's very easy. Sports, science, stuff like that is very easy, because it's all very measured. We know who the fastest person in the world is. We know who the best fighter in the world is, blah, 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 blah. But we don't necessarily know what we can get away with in an interaction, or what the norm is, or what's cool, or blah, 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 right? They're a lot more free-moving topics. It's a lot less exact. So going to basics, and again, I'm thinking about certain guys that I've worked with in the past, and lovely guys, but it's just, there's some foundational stuff that has to be sorted. Now, I'm going to talk about cleanliness, stuff like that. You can break all of these rules. If you're really good with girls, you can break these. You can stink and pick up girls, right? But let's just assume that we don't want that. Let's just assume that that sucks, and the new normal is that we're not gonna smell, right? So here's the foundation, right? So before you go out to look for girls, you must have showered, okay? And when you're in the shower, wash your armpits with soap, wash your nuts and dick with soap and your ass, wash your feet, and then come out, do your hair, like have some sort of a haircut. I know mine's like ridiculously shit at the moment, but I've got some sort of a haircut. And again, going back to that thing, my reality versus objective reality, I think it looks good, right? And especially when the blonde comes in, I'm gonna think it looks amazing. So if I was single and I was going out, it would really, I'd probably do quite well, because girls especially would buy into my frame of, oh, he thinks it looks good. And it's like a haircut is one of those things that's so subjective. If I back it to the hilt, who knows? A girl could well like it, right? Or she might just naturally like it, or she might just naturally dislike it. It's a difficult thing to get a grasp of that, right? But these basic things that we have to do, put deodorant on your underarms. So you've showered. This is your before going out prep to do day game or night game in a club. Mostly on this channel, we focus about night game in the club, because that's where it's the easiest and the best. That's where girls have gone to, they know in the back of their mind that they can get picked up there, and that's okay. They're not studying the library, don't want to be bothered, blah, blah, blah. It's a good place to go and pick them up. So let's assume you're going on a night out with your pals. You shower. you wash your armpits, you deodorize, right? And then when you come out, you can use EDT, Eau de Toilette, or EDP, Eau de Parfum. Eau de Parfum is lasts longer, it's nicer, it's more expensive, right? But just some sort of aftershave, right? So when she's in your circle, she can smell that aftershave on you. That's a sign of being an attractive man, right? That's a sign in her head, oh yeah, he gets it, he's an attractive man. And it's just pleasurable, and it's just nice, it smells good to her, right? It's alluring, right? It's attractive. Have some sort of a hairstyle before you go out. Like a lot of guys, guys who are worse with women generally, just have some, it's not a hairstyle, it's just like dank crap on top of their head, right? And it just grows out and they don't do anything with it and it looks, you groom yourself, right? Women pay attention to guys who groom themselves. So that's the basic things. Things like cutting your fingernails, cut them short. When guys have longer fingernails, it's always gross. Girls always think it's gross. I don't know why any guy does it. Style your facial hair if you want. I mean, and a lot of these things, right? So it's like, if you style it into this ridiculous, very pinpoint goatee, it might look strange, right? Or if you do 100 little cuts in your eyebrows to try and be fashionable, that'll look odd. But just like a neat beard looks good. Or if you're growing out your beard a little bit, have the barber cut it back, right? So it's like, it's trimmed, you've done something to it. You've had control over that, right? And that look, the fact that you've trimmed it, the fact that you've shaped it, just makes your essence that much stronger, right? It's a difficult thing to get your head around, but it's true. So they're basics, that's the new normal. There's not much time on the camera, so we're racing through this a little bit. moving on to sort of clothes, stuff like this. Look, you can see I'm wearing, these are fairly fashionable trainers, right? We're wearing slim jeans. We've got a very plain red t-shirt on. We've got a very cheap watch. And I've got this thing here, like a hairband, a girl's hairband that I wear around my wrist, right? So we can see, starting with the trainers. They're pretty cool trainers. They're upmarket, high tops. A lot of people don't like them. I like them. If you were going into a more trendy upmarket club in London, you could get in with most clubs with trainers like this, right? Really fashionable. High-end clubs will want you wearing shoes, so that's fine, you wear shoes. Slim fitting black jeans are great. It's just a great thing. It's so versatile, it looks good, black is good. Yeah, wear black jeans on a night out, slim fitting black jeans. Most important thing with clothes is it's the fit, right? So I wear, and again, it's that thing of we don't want a big barrier to entry. Look at what I'm wearing, none of this is very expensive. I like to wear a cross on my neck, just for sentimental reasons, and I think it looks quite cool. Girl can see, oh yeah, he's got a little necklace there, a little cross. A watch is good. This is super cheap, £15 watch my coworker was gonna throw out, and I was like, oh, actually, I'll go and I'll wear it. That's good enough. It doesn't need to be the big Rolex, right? I like this. This is a little gamey thing. I like just having something on this wrist as well. But it's a little bit gamey as well because she's thinking, oh, well, why is he wearing a girl's hairband, blah, blah, blah. It's a little bit social proof. We've gone over that topic before, right? You know what I mean? It's like pre-selection, other girl, or some other girl is giving him a hairband, or why is he wearing that? It's just quite cool. I quite like it. Although it doesn't matter too much, right? But yeah, that's clothes. I mean, if you wanna, look how basic this t-shirt is, right? But it's just plain, right? It's just plain, nice t-shirt. If I was, again, if the really upmarket club where you have to wear the shoes, I'd wear a nice plain shirt, white shirt, something like that is great. And the fit is the most important thing, right? And again, going back to that mindset of if you're really certain something will work, then it generally does, right? I mean, if I transferred my haircut onto one of my mates who hates my haircut, he would do a lot worse than I do because I think it looks good. And that's the only difference, really. Let's say our skill set is the exact same. He'll still do worse because he thinks he looks shit, whereas I think I look good with it. So that's that subjective meeting objective thing again. Yeah, to summarize, you know what to do before a night out. That's a fundamental, that's a no excuse, that's the new normal, has to be done. No one means to have all that power. The clock's ticking, I just count the hours. Stop tripping. It's a work in progress. So it's a work in progress, so I'm all right. Wash your nuts and dick with soap. But you have to shower on a night out. Jesus.